Want to speak real Japanese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at JapanesePod101.com.
Hi everyone! Welcome to Japanese Top Words! Today we are going to do 10 phrases to amaze native speakers.
Let's start!
ありがとうございます。でも実は私、ネイティブスピーカーではないんです。Thank you, but I'm not a native speaker, actually. ありがとうございます。でも、実は私、ネイティブスピーカーではないんです。Thank you, but I'm not a native speaker, actually.
おー、本当に？すっごい日本語上手だね。わー、びっくりした。
うまく話せるようになるのに1年しかかかりませんでした。It took me only 1 year to become fluent. うまく話せるようになるのに1年しかかかりませんでした。 It took me only 1 year to become fluent.
本当に？すご
っ。3年間でネイティブスピーカーのように日本語を話せるようになります。 I'll speak Japanese like a native speaker in 3 years. 3年間でネイティブスピーカーのように日本語を話せるようになります。 I'll speak Japanese like a native speakerIn 3 years.
おー、いい志だ、すごい。頑張れ、応援してる。
10年間、日本語を勉強してきました。I've been learning Japanese for 10 years. 10年間、日本語を勉強してきました。I've been learning Japanese for 10 years.
おー、すごい、継続力は、継続は力なり。
字幕なしで日本の映画を見ることができます。I can watch Japanese movies without subtitles. 字幕なしで日本語の映画を見ることができます。I can watch Japanese movies without subtitles.
へえ、すごい。
新しい日本語の単語を1日50語ぐらい覚えることができます。I can memorize around 50 new Japanese words a day.新しい日本語の単語を1日50語ぐらい覚えることができます。I can memorize around 50 Japanese words a day.
本当に？ちょっとその才能をください。
日本語以外にもいくつかの言語を話すことができます。Apart from knowing Japanese, I can speak a few other languages as well. 日本語以外にもいくつかの言語を話すことができます。Apart from knowing Japanese, I can speak a few other languages as well.
え、何語が喋れるの？すごいね。
独学で日本語を勉強しています。I'm learning Japanese all by myself. 独学で日本語を勉強しています。I'm learning Japanese all by myself.
おー、素晴らしい。絶対上手になるよ。
話していたことは全部わかりました。I completely understood everything you said. 話していたことは全部わかりました。I completely understand everything you said. 京都弁を話せます。I can speak Kyoto accent. 京都弁が話せます。I can speak Kyoto accent. おいでやす。Thank you for watching, everyone.何か日本の人と喋ってて驚かれたことはありますか？もしあったらぜひコメント欄で教えてください。じゃあまたね。Don't forget to subscribe. ほなさいなら。
For some, learning a new language seems to come naturally. For others, the entire process feels more like a tooth and nail struggle. However, if you've had a negative experience learning a new language at one point in time, don't let that discourage you from trying again.The truth is that learning any language is never easy, but it's definitely possible. Sometimes the difference between success and failure has less to do with your abilities or talents and a lot more to do with the way you look at things. In this video, we're going to look at how to avoid 5 serious mistakes made by new language learners. Number 1. Listen before you speak. Being slow to speak and quick to listen is good life advice, whether or not you're learning a foreign language.Effective listening is essential to communication. As a beginner, there is a tendency to concentrate so much on what you're going to say and how you're going to say it that you can completely miss the meaning or heart of what the other person is trying to communicate. Not only will this impair your ability to listen in your target language, it will also stall what little conversation you had going. Remember that conversations are a two-way street. If you're speaking more than listening, then you actually have more of a monologue on your hands than a dialogue. The inputs of language learning, listening and reading, are just as important as the outputs, speaking and writing. For a beginner, inputs are even more crucial, as they are the main way you acquire new vocabulary. We even go so far to say that for new students, the best method for learning involves more listening than it does speaking, though that may change with higher proficiency levels. Number two, don't be embarrassed when you do speak. People's next mistake usually comes from the other side of the spectrum, where new learners are too scared or embarrassed to contribute to a conversation. The fear of making mistakes and embarrassing yourself can paralyze your language learning. It's vital to remember that everyone makes mistakes. Even native speakers had to find their way through the language when they were children. Making mistakes while learning a new language is inevitable, but it's also a good thing. The faster you make mistakes, the quicker you can correct them and move on with your learning. So instead of being afraid to make mistakes, try looking at them as steps towards progress. In reality, that's what they really are. Number three, don't fixate on minor issues. If taken in all at once, a new language can feel overwhelming to learn. It's so easy to get discouraged by all your little mistakes and conversational mishaps, and you lose sight of the progress you're making. In addition to mistakes, you'll also come across plateaus, where you study and practice consistently, but don't see any results for a significant amount of time. But whether you face errors or plateaus, remember that these things are minor obstacles on the road to fluency. The most important thing is not to give up. Stick with it. If you stay persistent, your mistakes will be corrected and your abilities will improve. But if you slow down or throw in the towel completely, then you'll either subvert your progress or nix it altogether. So remember that as long as you're still studying and learning the language, you can't lose. It might feel like you're losing the battle for language learning for a little while, but hang in there. A practical way to help you stay motivated is to make small weekly goals. Research shows that goal setting has a significant impact on learning. Try picking one aspect of grammar or a collection of new words or phrases to study for the next 7 days. At the end of the week, check your progress and measure your success. Setting little benchmarks like this will give you a rightful sense of accomplishment. Number four, remember that immersion isn't magical. A lot of people think that by moving to a foreign country, they will learn the language by osmosis. But whether you learn abroad or at home, you still need to study and practice the language. Living in a new country gives you way more opportunities to do this than staying at home. But if you don't consciously take advantage of these opportunities while living abroad, it won't benefit your language learning. If you're an expat living in a foreign country, there's a natural inclination to hang out around other expats. Learning a language and living in a foreign culture is hard and uncomfortable. For better or worse, we're often drawn to the easier road. If you made the decision to study abroad, then you want to hang out with native-speaking people as much as possible. You have the rest of your life to be with people who speak your language. This doesn't mean ignore your expat friends. Just be sure that you're giving proper attention to your language learning. Languages are better lived than they are learned. Number five, be open-minded. Languages are better lived than they are learned. When learning a new language, your brain will want to conform the new grammar and vocabulary to your native language norms and grammar rules. Ignore your brain on this one. At first, you might feel completely wrong saying a sentence that is, in fact, correct. After a certain point in language learning, there is a switch that goes off, when your brain finally realizes that you're not speaking your native language, but a new one altogether. This could take a while, though, especially if this is your first time learning a new language. Until then, do what you know is correct, even if it feels a bit weird when you say it. The same goes for culture. Just as you want to be open to the differences in the language, don't forget to be open to the differences in the culture, too. Hopefully, this video helped you shift your thinking and approach language learning in a way that will help you become fluent faster, and that you'll learn to enjoy the journey towards fluency and savor the language for its own sake. That's probably the biggest language learning secret there is. And for even more ways to get started learning a new language, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye!
Welcome to Japanese Often Phrase That Makes You Like a Fool. Hi everyone! Welcome to Japanese Top Words. Today we're gonna do Top 10 Phrases That Make You Look Like a Fool. Let's start! あなたが成功することは決してないだろう。You never succeed.あなたが成功することは決してないだろう。You'll never succeed. そんなことない。You'll succeed. 成功する。大丈夫。あなたのアドバイスはいらないよ。I don't need your advice. あなたのアドバイスはいらないよ。I don't need your advice. あなたは全然賢くないね。You're not very smart. あなたは全然賢くないね。You are not very smart. 大丈夫、頭いいから。それはあまりにも難しい。挑戦もしない方がいい。It's too hard. Don't even try. それはあまりにも難しい。挑戦もしない方がいい。It's too hard. Don't even try. What? それはあまりにも難しい。挑戦もしない方がいい。大丈夫です、やってみます。私たちにそれはできないよ。We can't do that. 私たちにそれはできないよ。We can't do that. 私たちにそれはできないよ。私はもう何も学ぶ必要はありません。I don't need to learn anything anymore.
私はもう何も学ぶ必要はありません。
謙虚になるということを学んだらどうでしょうか。私は何でも知っている。I know everything.
私は何でも知っている。I know everything.
私は何でも知っている。
I know everything. キランキラン。
私が言うようにやって。Just do what I say. 私が言うようにやって。結構です。私は日本語を勉強する準備ができていないんだ。
I'm not ready to learn Japanese.
私は日本語を勉強する準備ができていないんだ。
私は…
Yes, you can!
私は正しくて、あなたが間違っている。
I'm right and you're wrong.
私は正しくて、あなたが間違っている。私は正しくて、
あなたが間違っている。
すいません、間違ってました。
Thank you for watching. Today we did top 10 phrases that makes you look like a fool. Don't forget to subscribe.
Kiran, kiran.
Want to speak real Japanese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at JapanesePod101.com.
So, you decided to learn a new language. At first, the idea seemed exciting. You bought a phrase book.Dictionary, and a subscription to an online class, ready to dive headfirst into the language. For the first day or two, all was well. You gained ground quickly, learning a few basic phrases and words. A week before, learning that language was just a dream, but now you're actually doing it. Then, the third and fourth day roll around. The excitement is wearing off. You encouraged yourself to continue, and another week or two goes by, but with a lot less progress.Suddenly, learning a new language doesn't fill you with excitement anymore. Now it feels more like dread. Sometimes it feels like you're drowning in grammatical cases, verb conjugations, and wonky pronunciation. It all seems too much to handle, so you start to think about giving up. But we encourage you not to give up. Learning a foreign language is difficult. We won't pretend like it isn't. But that doesn't mean you can't do it.Sometimes you just need to take a step back, reevaluate your approach, and come back to the language with a different perspective. In this video, we'll look at four tips for when learning a new language feels overwhelming. Number one, set aside a designated study time. Consistency is key when learning a foreign language. Studying 15 minutes 7 days a week will benefit you more than cramming in 2 hours 1 day a week. Set aside an amount of time that works best for you. If you can afford to spend an hour every day learning, that's awesome. Go for it. But don't feel bad if you can't spend that much time. Even 10 or 15 minutes a day goes a long way. Breaking up your learning into manageable time segments will relieve a lot of the stress that can come with studying a new language. Learning is not a race. Go at your own pace and try not to compare your progress with anyone else's. Number two, take it one bite at a time. Now that you have your schedule under control, it's time to focus on what you'll actually be studying. It's recommended that every 1 to 2 weeks, you focus on learning a very specific piece of the language. It could be a conjugation group, a case, tense, or a collection of theme vocabulary. Whatever you choose, hone in on it and do your best to feel comfortable with it before you move on to something else. Ever heard the saying, "How do you eat an elephant?" Focusing on one thing at a time helps you break the language into digestible chunks. Number three, expose yourself to the language in different ways. Don't just sit around reading about grammar all day. Obviously, knowledge of grammar is important, but you want to spice up your practice as much as possible. In addition to grammatical study, try to mix in a combination of reading, writing, speaking, and listening. Try to practice reading by either translating a simple article into your native language, or maybe if you're a beginner, pick up a children's book in your target language. For writing, you can try to write out a fictional conversation between you and yourself, even. Use the phrases you know to create a mock conversation, and don't use any words you can't think of or you don't remember. To practice speaking, you can find native speakers locally at a language club or at a meetup. You can also find them online in a language exchange. For listening, a great podcast should do the trick. Spread out each type of practice, listening, reading, speaking, and writing, across your regular language study schedule. This will give you a balanced experience in the language and should help keep things interesting. This method also works well when you use it to focus on a single aspect of the language like we talked about above. Number four, set mini goals, not just big ones. If your only language learning goal is to be fluent, you're likely setting yourself up for disappointment. While speaking fluently can be your ultimate goal, it shouldn't be your only one. Try to set mini goals month by month and week by week. It could be something simple. Learn 20 new verbs, practice a new case, or speak with 3 native speakers. As long as it's specific and reasonable to achieve in a shorter amount of time, it should work fine. Not having mini goals alongside your ultimate goal is a lot like sprinting across a huge open field. There's no reference point, so for much of the time, it feels like you're not any closer to your goal. It's not that you're not moving forward, it just feels like you're not. Without any trees or buildings to run past, it seems like you're running in place. Mini goals are like the trees and buildings of your language race. They help you see that you're moving forward and give you a sense of accomplishment. The desire for perfection can get in the way of your progress. Don't freak out when you struggle to speak or make a mistake. It's all a part of the learning process. Also, don't be afraid to speak, even if you know what you'll say won't be totally correct. It's better to do your best to communicate in the language and get it wrong than to never try at all. Learning a new language isn't always easy. In fact, oftentimes it's very hard. Don't let that discourage you, though. Use these tips to help keep you focused yet unstressed in your language learning. A little perseverance will go a long way. Before long, you'll be speaking better than you may have thought was possible. And for even more help learning a new language without getting overwhelmed, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hey guys, this is Risa. Today we're gonna do top 10 hardest words to pronounce. Let's go. Yoshi. Twitter でつぶやく。Say something on Twitter. Tweet.
やったことない、Twitter。
チクチクっていうね。す。あ、マウになっちゃった。
な、
う。あ、マウな。なんでな。な、う。スタジオナウ。I'm in the studio. 多分この Twitter が難しいのは、つっていう発音が結構外国の人には難しいみたいで、それが一番初めについてるからちょっと難しいのかもしれないです。Twitter。つつつ
つ伝えられなかった。 could not tell、 これもつから始まってます。伝えられなかった、確かにちょっと難しいかもしれないですね、言われると。本当の気持ちを伝えられなかった。ダン、
侵略、 invasion、 侵略。
多分このリャが言いにくいんじゃないですかね。
リャ、リャリュリョ、リに小さいヤです。リャ、リャ、リャ
敵の陣地に侵略する。
わ
ー、便利、 convenient、 便利。コンビニは便利。 convenience store is convenient。 ラリルレロ、ラリルレロ、ラリルレロ、便利。これ言いづらいですかね。便利、リ、リかな。出力、 output power、 つ、つ、リ、つもリも入ってる。出力、出、つ、りょ、く、出力、出力装置、 output power device。
これは確かにちょっと言いにくいですね。
こうやってもしかしたら首をこうやって出力って言ったら言いやすいかもしれない。出力、
店員、 clerk、
店員なんですけど、喋ってる時は店員みたいな、ちょっと伸ばす感じですかねっていうと言いやすいです。
店員、
店員、店員、店員、難しいですね。店員、
店員、
店員さんを呼ぶ、 call the clerk。 すいません、すいません、よくレストランで日本で店員さんを呼ぶときはすいませんって結構大きな声出して言うので、もしかしたらびっくりするかもしれないです。
いらっしゃいませ、こんにちは
旅行、 traveling、 旅行、旅行、う、旅行に行く。
ウィ
ーブーン、マチュピチュ行ってきます。暖かくなかった、 was not warm。 暖かくなかった、
暖かくなかった、
暖かくなかった、暖かくなかった、暖かくなかった。 when you use this phrase I think normally people say 暖かくなかった、暖かい、暖かくなかった。暖かい is a short way to say 暖かい。In a former situation, you'd better to say 暖かい。駐車場、 parking lot、 駐車場、 parking lot、 駐車場、駐車場、駐車場に車を止める。駐車場、駐車場。
お
ー、テンタン、テンタン、あ、何これ、テンタン、テンタン、テンタン、おー、ドブーおっちょこちょい、 clumsy、 おっちょこちょいな女の子、 a clumsy girl。
うわー、こぼしちゃった、あ、すいません、あ
おっちょこちょい、おっちょこちょい、おっちょこちょい、おっちょこちょい、 clumsy。 Thank you for watching! See you next time! Bye for now!
おっちょこちょい、おっちょこちょい。
Want to speak your target language with confidence and impress native speakers?When learning to speak a new language, you have lots of things to think about, including grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. Because you're thinking of all of these things and trying to speak, it can be difficult to communicate with confidence, especially in the beginning. This is why it's helpful to make confidence-building exercises part of your language learning process. In this video, you'll learn 7 ways to boost your confidence. 1. Read out loud.This might seem pretty basic, but it's a great way to practice speaking. Reading aloud lets you practice speaking without having to think about grammar or things to talk about. Reading out loud lets you focus on your pronunciation and the rhythm of the language. It can help you learn to speak more smoothly and quickly, without even thinking about it. If you're using our lessons, read the dialogue out loud as you listen. You can read along with the dialogue tool, the lesson notes, or the transcript. 2. Read like a child.This might sound strange, but think about children learning to read. They go slow and sound everything out. Maybe it takes 2 or 3 tries before they read a new word smoothly, and a few more tries before they can read it at a natural pace. This example applies to language learning too. If you find a complex sentence in something you're reading, read it slowly at first, then speed up. With practice, you'll be able to say it easily.It might feel a bit silly to speak very slowly, but this kind of practice can help you identify tough sounds you might miss or say incorrectly when reading quickly. 3. Use the dialogue breakdown tool. If you're using our site, this is a great tool to take advantage of. It breaks down lesson conversations into individual lines. You can listen to the audio for each line, learn what each line means, and can reread and review as much as you want. 4. Use the voice recorder to record and compare yourself with native speakers. Just click on the microphone icon next to each line in the dialogue section. You can use this tool to perfect your pronunciation if you like, but this is also something you can use to work on speaking with confidence at native level speed. You'll find this tool in the dialogue section of all of our lessons. 5. Repeat and review old lesson conversations. Reviewing what you've studied in the past is the best way to make sure you maintain what you've learned. Go back to older lessons, download the lesson dialogue tracks, and re-listen to the conversations again and again. Or you can reread the dialogue lines from previous lessons until you've mastered them all. 6. Shadow conversations. Repeat what you hear out loud. This tactic is important, but it can be tricky when you're doing a brand new lesson. If you're reviewing dialogues from lessons you've done, though, it's super easy to do. Just listen to the dialogue and repeat what you hear. Shadowing means mimicking the speaker as soon as they speak, following their intonation and rhythms as closely as possible. 7. Send recordings to your Premium Plus teacher. If you want to speak with confidence, there's no better confidence boost than feedback from a native speaker, and you get just that with a Premium Plus teacher. You can record yourself reciting a lesson dialogue or any dialogue of your own, and your teacher will give you specific tips on how to improve. From the tips your teacher gives you, choose at least one and practice, practice, practice. Being able to react quickly and with confidence in a conversation is typically not something you can do on your first try, but if you continue practicing, you'll gradually find yourself speaking with ease. And for even more ways to build your speaking confidence, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Japanese. Top words. Today's theme is 10 ways to remember words. Let's go!
なるべくネイティブと話をする。I speak as often as possible with native speakers.
皆さん、日本人の友達はいますか？もし日本語を勉強してて、ね、なんかチャンスがあれば、日本人の友達作ったら上達する早道になるかもしれません。
何回も読んだり書いたり話したりを繰り返しする。
I use repetition, reading and writing and speaking words over and over again.
海外にイギリスに行ってたことがあるんですけど、そこで英語勉強するときにバスに乗りながらネイティブの人たちの会話のモノマネを一人でコソコソしたりしてました。
秘密秘密That's what I'm saying! とかだけど見つかったらちょっと怪しいから気をつけてください。
子供向けのテレビや YouTube をよく見る。
I often watch TV or YouTube videos that are designed for young children.
子供向けのテレビアニメとかだったら結構簡単な会話が出てくるからおすすめです。日常生活の中でいつも使うようにする。
I try to use the language routinely in the context or daily life.
例えば相手が日本人の人じゃなくても、まあ独り言とかでもいいんですけど、その言葉を使うようにする。外国の人ってなんか、おっとっていうのを、英語系の人なんですけど、ウップスって言うじゃないですか。それを、日常生活の中で私も真似してたんです、わざと。ウープスとか。そしたら日本に帰ってきてなんかぶつかった時にウープスって言ったりしてちょっと恥ずかしい思いしたことあります。日本語で考えようとすると頭の中も自然に日本語になる。
I try to think in Japanese so it becomes natural to my thought process. これは確かに外国の自分の母国語で考えて日本語を喋るよりもなるべく日本語で考えてから喋った方がスムーズに出てくるようになると思います。結構難しいんですけどね、そのプロセスが。家族や犬に向かって理解されなくても話し続ける。 I am persistent in practicing every day by talking to my family or my dogs even though they don't understand me. 毎日やっぱり何か誰か相手を作って話すというのが大事なんですね。弟と一緒に住んでるんですけど、喧嘩した時に英語で文句言ったりしますそうすると分かんないからね。ダメダメ新聞をできるだけ読むと言葉を覚えるのに役立つ。 Reading as much as possible especially the newspaper helps me to remember words。 あと新聞だけじゃなくてラジオでニュースを聞いてそれの真似をするのもいいかもしれません。簡単な文章の中に新しい言葉を使ってみると単体の言葉だけでなく文章全体を勉強できる。 I try to use the new word in a simple sentence so I learn whole phrases not just individual words。 例えば何か一つ言うにしても新しい言葉を覚えてそれを文章の中に使うことによってなんかいろんな言い回しが増えて文も覚えれて一石二鳥ということですかね。一石二鳥、 killing two birds with one stone。 一石二鳥覚えてください。音楽を聴いて歌詞を暗記する。 I listen to the song and memorize the lyrics。 私が外国語を勉強するときはだいたい音楽から入ることが多くて、初めは意味わからなくてもそのまま真似して歌ったりして後々になって意味が理解できるっていうことが結構あります。セタブロマンセチューヌベリストア。皆さんのなんか好きな日本の曲あれば教えてください。実際に自分に聞こえるように言葉を声に出す。 I say words out loud so that I can actually hear them。頭の中で読むだけじゃなくて口に出すことによってより覚えが早くなると思います。私も経験上、うん、Don't be shy、 どんどん言っていったらいいと思いますよ。今日は以上です。 That's it for today。 なんか皆さん今日のその勉強法で一番好きな方法はどれですか？あともし今日出てなかったものでもおすすめの勉強法があればぜひ教えてください。ではまた、バイバイ。Bye bye. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye.
Hey everyone, welcome to your monthly review. The monthly show on language learning, where you discover new learning strategies, motivational tips, new study tools, resources, and where we show off learners like you speaking the language. That is, if you're brave enough to participate and become language learning famous. All the materials mentioned in this video are available for you right now on our website. Click the link in the description to sign up for your free lifetime account and start speaking in minutes. Okay, today's topic is why your worst days are the best days to study. So, have you ever had a day where you planned on learning language and you just couldn't go through with it? Even if learning a new language is your personal goal, something that you really want? Well, today you're going to learn one, why these bad days happen, and two, why you'll get your best work done on your worst days. But first, here's a quick update on what's going on in Japan right now, December 2018. If you're planning on visiting Japan in December, the weather will range from cool down south in Kyushu to proper winter cold from Kyoto to everything up north. Tokyo, however, can be very warm on sunny days. You may also see snow in the mountainous regions. December is also known for winter illuminations. These are LED light festivals and displays that you can see all over Tokyo, on trees, on buildings, in shopping centers. These illuminations give Japan a warm winter spirit and make perfect date spots. Some famous winter illuminations in Japan are the Marunouchi Illumination in Tokyo, the Kobe Luminarie and the Sendai Pageant of Starlight. Next, if you're into skiing or snowboarding, you'll be able to kick off your snow season in December in Japan. Many snow resorts start opening up in mid-December. These resorts double as hot spring resorts, or onsen. Some popular spots for skiing are Hakuba and Shigakogen in Nagano. Next is Christmas. Christmas is a Western import, but it's not as family-oriented as it is in the West, so there's not much gift-giving. Instead, it's more for couples and shopping, so you'll see couples going out for a romantic dinner. But there is a very unique Japanese Christmas tradition, getting chicken at KFC. This started as a Christmas campaign by KFC called Christmas with KFC. They were inspired by a foreigner who went to a KFC store to buy chicken instead of Christmas turkey because he couldn't find a turkey in Japan. And finally, the New Year. Once Christmas is done, New Year's is right around the corner. The Japanese tradition is to visit a temple on New Year's Eve and eat toshikoshi soba, buckwheat noodles. You can welcome the New Year by listening to the toll of the temple bell. Or you can visit popular spots like Shibuya Crossing in Tokyo and count down with everyone. Now, let's jump into today's topic. Let's start. Why bad days happen with language learning. When I say bad days, I don't mean when you're too busy or when life gets in the way. These things are unavoidable. I mean days when you're just not in the mood. It's a perfectly good day, the sun is shining, no bad news, but you just can't get yourself to study. You're just wasting the day. So here's why they happen. First, it's the law of diminishing returns in action. What does this mean? Think of it as eating pizza every day for 5 days a week. On the first day, the first two slices are great, but by the third one, you're feeling queasy. It's not as good. And by the fifth day, you're sick of pizza. That's the law of diminishing returns, when the benefits start decreasing over time. And it happens with language learning. When you first start, you learn a lot of phrases and it feels good. You're excited. But as time goes on, you don't feel like you're learning much. And this affects your mood and motivation. So you're not as excited to learn anymore. So you start having bad days. Second, bad days happen because you overthink things and ruin it for yourself. It's like dreading going to the gym. Let's say you went yesterday. You have to go again today. So you're dreading it all day long. Ah, I gotta go again. You set yourself up for a bad mood and a bad day. Third, bad days are a natural part of the cycle. Some days will be good. Most days you'll feel indifferent. Some days will be bad. But that's completely natural, and anyone with long-term projects and goals feels the same. And fourth, you can't be on 100% of the time. So just like days can't always be good, you too can't always be on and ready to go all the time. Again, just a realistic and expected part of the journey. Now, let's jump into the second part, why you'll get your best work done on your worst days. So, why will you get your best work done? First, it's not that bad once you start. Once you've spent 10 or 15 minutes learning a language, it's not so bad. People say the same thing about the gym. If you show up and put in a bit of time, it gets easier. Second, it's overcoming a mental barrier. What I mean is, when most of us have bad days, our brain automatically says, okay, can't be done today, stop, we're done. But if you just work through it, you don't take these bad days so seriously anymore. And that means you're more likely to stick with your language learning goal. This brings us to the next point. Third, it's your best work because working on a bad day only strengthens your habit of language learning. Remember, habits are what will help you master a language over time. If you can stick to a habit on a bad day, your habit only gets stronger, and it will lead you to fluency. And finally, fourth, it just feels good to overcome something. Imagine you have a bad day, but you still put in 10 minutes of language learning. It's a real sense of achievement. And it doesn't matter if you do a 10-minute lesson or a 5-minute lesson. The fact that you made some progress on a bad day will give you the motivation you need to keep going. Now, speaking of lessons, here are this month's new lessons and resources. First, the Best of 2018 Language Learning Cheat Sheets. If you want to get access to all of our conversation cheat sheets that we sent out this year, here's your chance. Download this PDF bundle right now. Next, the brand new Supermarket Cheat Sheet. With this cheat sheet, you'll learn must-know shopping phrases and vocab for meats, vegetables, and all products that you'll find in a supermarket. And finally, the most common adjectives. If you're a beginner and don't yet know these adjectives, then this is a perfect chance to boost your vocabulary. This one-minute lesson will get them stuck in your head, guaranteed. To get these free lessons and resources, just click the link in the description below. All right, everyone. In the last monthly review, we asked you to submit a video or audio file of yourself speaking the language, introducing yourself in the language. So thank you to all of you that sent in submissions. You've all received a Premium Plus subscription as a reward. Now, here to help me analyze all of your great submissions is my fellow Japanese Pod 101 host, Risa. Over to you, Risa.
Hi, everyone. Alicia sent me some of your submissions, and I can't wait to take a look at them. So let's just dive right in. So now I'm going to have a look at the submissions. I'm excited. Let's go. First one is this one.
はじめまして。私はドリと申します。インドから話しています。日本語は面白いと思います。から勉強しています。
素晴らしい。
どうぞよろしくお願いします、リーサさん。
Oh, 嬉しい。And the correction. Thank you. It's amazing. Perfect. インドから、なんだっけな。サワディーカ? Thank you. It's amazing. And the next one? Okay. It's a video next time.
Okay. みなさん、はじめまして。私はリバです。どうぞよろしく。私の出身はアメリカのオハイオです。
おう、オハイオ。
新しい言語を学ぶのが大好きですので、日本語を勉強しています。
素晴らしい。
私は日本語をまあまあ話せます。でも、スペイン語をよく話せます。ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。嬉しいですね。ビデオでありがとうございます。素晴らしい、スムーズな日本語でした。And next one, this one. Play.
こんにちは。はじめまして。
はじめまして。
私はベトリスです。
ベアトリスさん。
でも、ベティと呼んでください。
はい。
32歳です。
うんうん。
メキシコの出身です。カンクンに住んでいます。
カンクン。
10くらい間日本語を勉強しています。日本に行きたいです。
お
の仕事に役立ちますも。
うんうん。
じゃあね。
じゃあね。Thank you. So she's Betty from Cancun, Mexico.Nice try, thank you. And next one is a video again. Okay.
こんにちは。
こんにちは。
私はノマンです。出身はパキスタンです。
パキスタン。
日本語が好きです。
ほう。
私は日本語。私は日本語を勉強です。勉強したい。
勉強したい。
That's all?
That's all? Thank you! Good try! 私は日本語を勉強したいです。Nice one! パキスタンからでした。And the last one?
はじめまして。私の名前は、
はい、
ビクター・クレアです。どうぞよろしくお願いします。私はフランスに住んでいます。
はい、
日本の文化が大好きなので、
うん、
今、日本語を勉強しているのです。私の夢はいつか日本に行くことです。
ぜひ。
だから、毎日日本語の練習をしています。 私のメッセージを聞いたので、うん、ありがとうございました。
こちらこそメッセージありがとうございました。ビクターさん、フランスからすごくスムーズな日本語です。 So smooth, thank you. So this month we've got more submissions compared to last month. I'm so happy about that. Thank you so much, guys. Amazing work, everybody. Thank you so much for your submissions. Back to you, Alicia.
So, which entry did you like the best? Leave a comment below. Or, do you think you can do better?All right, everyone. Now we're asking you to submit a video or audio file of yourself speaking the language. If you do, you'll win 3 free months of access to our learning program, which includes your very own teacher. Here's the challenge for you. Yes, everyone watching this. Record a 30-second to 1-minute video or audio clip. Introduce yourself in the language. Share your name, where you're from, and why you're studying this language. And you'll win a 3-month Premium Plus subscription. To submit,Click on the link in the description. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Then, fill out the form. Attach the audio or video file and press submit. We may feature you in next month's episode. So a lot of learners will see you and your progress and will hopefully get inspired to improve and master the language. To submit a recording, click the link in the description and follow the instructions on the page. So thank you for watching this episode of Monthly Review.Next time, we'll talk about how to set achievable language learning goals and resolutions. In the meantime, submit your recording, if you're brave. Like and share this video, and leave a comment to tell us what language learning tactics you'd like us to talk about. See you next time. Bye! Hey, everyone! Welcome to your monthly review.The monthly show on language learning, where you discover new learning strategies, motivational tips, new study tools, resources, and where we show off learners like you speaking the language. That is, if you're brave enough to participate and become language learning famous. All the materials mentioned in this video are available for you right now on our website. Click the link in the description to sign up for your free lifetime account and start speaking in minutes. Okay, today's topic is...How to set achievable language goals and resolutions, your New Year's resolution solution. So, for those of you that have set a language goal for 2019, what is it? Leave a comment and tell me. And for those of you that laugh at New Year's resolutions because they just don't work, this is for you. Stick around. Today, you're going to learn, number one, the top 3 reasons why language goals fail, and number 2, what you can do to succeed with your resolution.In other words, how to set successful language goals. But first, here's what's going on in Japan right now, January 2019. If you're planning on visiting Japan in January, you should know that flight tickets and hotels are extra expensive this time of year. And that's mostly because of the spike in travel during the holiday season. January is also one of the colder months, and after the New Year's holiday has passed,There are a lot fewer tourists, so this makes it a great time to visit hot springs, shrines in Kyoto, and ski resorts, and not deal with crowds. Actually, this month is peak ski season, since this is when resorts report having the heaviest snowfall. Now, if you're in Japan in the beginning of January, then you should know about Hatsumode, which means the first shrine visit of the new year.As a New Year custom, Japanese people visit Shinto shrines to pray for the New Year to be a good one. And everyone is welcome to do this ritual, even if you don't follow the Shinto religion. Sensoji in Asakusa is one of the more popular shrines in Tokyo. And from January 1st to the 5th, you can also see traditional dance performances there, which bring out large crowds. Another January Japanese tradition is Coming of Age Day, or Seijin no Hi in Japanese.This happens on the second Monday of January and is a national holiday. On this day, anyone who turns 20 years old this year celebrates their entry into adulthood. They gather for a special ceremony held by their local city office and then go out with their friends. 20 is also the legal drinking age, so many will take advantage of their new status. So you'll typically notice large groups of young women in kimonos or young men in suits or kimonos with hakama. And finally, January is a big shopping season. On January 2nd, many department stores offer fukubukuro bags, or lucky bags, which contain around 5 items. The catch is, you won't know what's inside until you've bought it. And every bag usually contains at least one expensive item. But remember, it's all up to chance. You might get some expensive item that you don't really need. Let's jump into today's topic, how to set achievable language goals and resolutions. And speaking of New Year's resolutions, it's almost like a joke nowadays, isn't it? You set a resolution, you try to do it in January. By February, there's no progress and doing it isn't fun anymore. You quit and put it off until many years later when you start regretting all the things you've never done. So what's the problem with setting resolutions and why do we keep failing? Let's jump into part one, the top three reasons why language goals fail. First of all, regardless of what most people say, setting resolutions or goals is a good thing. You have to know where you're going and what you want to achieve, right? Otherwise, you'd spend days, months, years watching YouTube and have nothing to show for all the time you put in. But the problem with most resolutions is it's usually something like, I want to master Chinese, I want to lose weight, I want to be fluent in Japanese. People set very big, vague goals. And that's the first reason why resolutions fail. Resolutions fail because they are non-specific and unmeasurable. What do I mean by that? Take a goal like, I want to be fluent in English, Korean, or Japanese this year. The problem is, that's a very vague goal, right? What do you mean by fluent? And how can you measure how much progress you need to be fluent in the language? You can't. It doesn't tell you anything about how much Japanese you should learn today, tomorrow, or how many minutes of Japanese to speak by month one, by month two, what resources to use, and when to stop and take a rest. So again, the first reason is resolutions fail because they are non-specific and unmeasurable. The second reason is New Year's resolutions fail because they're unrealistic. And you might say, but isn't it good to aim for the stars and set huge goals? Sure, it's not bad to want to go far, but if you say, I want to be fluent by September, and you just started learning a language today, it's not impossible, but are you ready to commit yourself to nothing but language learning, 6 to 8 hours a day, nonstop? If not, you need to be a little more realistic about your goals. The third reason is resolutions fail because there's no action plan. The problem is you'll still fail, even with a specific and realistic goal, if you don't know when and how you're going to do it. For example, when will you study? How long will you study for every day? And how will you study? So resolutions fail for three reasons. One, they're non-specific and unmeasurable. Two, they're unrealistic. And three, there's no action plan. Now, how do you set New Year's resolutions and actually succeed? Your goals should be one, specific and measurable, two, realistic, and three, have an action plan. So the complete opposite of the mistakes most learners usually make. And there are two more rules. Four, you need to set a deadline. And five, break down your yearly goal into smaller monthly goals. So how would this work? Let's say my New Year's resolution is to have a 30-minute conversation in Japanese by December 31st, and not, I want to learn Japanese one day, hopefully. Already, you can see that it's one, specific and measurable. You can measure 30 minutes, right? Two, it's realistic. I'm aiming for 30 minutes, not fluency. There's a clear deadline, December 31st. Before we get into the action plan, there's another important part. I break my resolution down into smaller monthly goals. So let's say my goal is to speak 2 minutes of Japanese conversation by January 31st, 2019. Again, it's small and measurable, just 2 minutes. I can time myself and see how far along I am. There's a clear deadline. It's realistic. I'm not looking to master the whole language, just reach the 2-minute conversation mark. Now, what about your action plan? For that, you just need to answer these questions. When will you study? How long will you study every day? Where do you plan to study? How will you study? What's your study schedule? This is the most important part because this tells you when and how to study. So, when will you study? I'll study at 9 p.m. on weekdays, so 5 days a week. How long will you study every day? I'll study for 15 minutes. Where do you plan to study? I'll study at home, in the living room, on my computer. How will you study? I'll listen to one or two lessons a day to fill up the 15 minutes. What's your study schedule? Monday through Friday for 15 minutes a day. This makes a lot more sense now, doesn't it? Instead of saying, hopefully I'll learn that language someday, and never taking action on your goals, by setting these small, measurable goals, you know what you need to do. Okay, let's recap. To set successful language goals, your goals should be 1. Specific and measurable, 2. Realistic, 3. Have an action plan, 4. A deadline, and 5. Be broken down into small monthly goals. So instead of saying, I want to be fluent in 2019, try, I want to speak 30 minutes of conversation by December 31st, 2019. And then go even smaller and set a small monthly goal. So everyone, it's your turn. Leave a comment and tell me, what's your small, measurable, monthly goal? And what's the deadline? Here are some examples you can steal for yourself. Learn 100 words in 1 month. Speak 1 minute of your target language in a month. Or do 20 audio lessons in 1 month. Deadline, January 31st. Now, speaking of lessons, here are this month's new lessons and resources. First, the Ultimate Listening Video Master Course. Honest question, how sharp are your listening skills? With this Video Master Course, they'll be as sharp as a razor. Download it right now. Next, the Talk About Your Body PDF Cheat Sheet. With this cheat sheet, you'll learn words for parts of your body in the target language. Then, there's the Most Common Texting Slang Word List. If you want to text in the language you're learning, you'll love this. You'll learn how to say LOL and other words in your target language. And finally, the How to Express Quantity Vocab List, where you learn how to say if there's a lot, a few, or a little bit of something. To get these free lessons and resources, just click the link in the description below. All right, everyone. In the last monthly review, we asked you to submit a video or audio file of yourself speaking the language, introducing yourself in the language. So thank you to all of you that sent in submissions. You've all received a Premium Plus subscription as a reward. Now let's take a look at some of the videos. Here to help me analyze all of your great submissions is my fellow Japanese Pod 101 host, Risa. Over to you, Risa.
Hi, everyone. Alicia sent me some of your submissions, and I can't wait to take a look at them. So let's just dive right in. Thank you for your submissions. I'm looking forward to see them. Let's watch. Play.
はじめまして、ブライアン・モアと申します。
ブライアンさん、はじめまして。
どうぞよろしくお願いします。
お願いします。
アメリカのノースカロライナに住んでいます。
ノースカロライナから。
2000年から日本のエンジニアと仕事をしました。私は読んで書く話したいします。でも会話は難しい。助けてください。
最後の助けてくださいが面白いですね。そうなんだ、日本の方と働いてたんですね。会話、そうですね、普段から日本語を話せる相手がいないとなかなか上達が難しいですよね。
はじめまして、私はチトラです。
チトラさん。
私はインド人です。私は2歳から日本の学生です。
2歳から日本の学生はどういうことだろう。
私は日本の技術が大好きで、日本に住みたいので日本語を勉強しています。ありがとうございます。
チトラさん、どんな日本の美術が好きなんですか。気になりますね、チトラさん。インドからありがとうございます。
こんにちは、私の名前はエヴァ・フェルナンダ。
エヴァさん。
エヴァと呼んでください。はい、私はメキシコ出身です。
メキシコからです。
私はアニメが好きです。うん、私はスペイン語と英語を話す。日本語は美しく、面白くて難しいと思います。
そうですね。
といつか日本に旅行したい。
ぜひ。
よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
じゃあね。
お、かわいい。じゃあね。エヴァさん、ありがとうございます。Next one。お、次ビデオだ。OK。
Play.
こんにちは、ヨナスです。
国は、ヨナスさん、こんにちは。
お、ドイツです。これはアメリカ。そして、これは日本です。情報工学の学生です。毎日ひらがなとかカタカナを書きます。
すごいちゃんと練習してる。
これは今日の読む書く練習です。
今日の書く練習。
どうして日本語を勉強しますか。
自分で質問してくれてる。6年
前にぐらい初めてアニメを見ました。そして今年中に大学で日本語のコースをしました。そしてもっと日本語の勉強したいでした。
もっと日本語の勉強したいと思いました。
発音とひらがなとカタカナが好きです。
はい。
すべての教育漢字の意味を知りますけど、単語はまだまだです。ドイツ人のヨナスでした。バイバイ。
ありがとうございます。ちゃんと地図でどこか教えてくれてありがとうございます。ヨナスさん、情報工学の学生だそうです。これ、サブタイトルって自分でつけたんでしょうかね。すごい。読みやすいです。Thank you! Danke schön! 次が、これか。プレイ、あ、プレイ。
こんにちは、リザさん。
こんにちは。
ケビンと言います。
ケビンさん。
私はフランスに住んでいます。
お、フランス。
どうして日本語を勉強しますか？
どうしてですか？
私は日本に働きたいですから。
おお。
夢があります。声優になりたい。
おお、声優になりたい。日本のアニメの声優かな。
リザさんのビデオを見ています。
うん、ありがとうございます。
いつも面白かったと思います。
お、面白いと言われると嬉しい。
また続いてください。
ありがとうございます。
さようなら。
さようなら。どうもありがとうございます。嬉しいな。面白いって言われるの嬉しいですね。OK, next one。来た。
こんにちは、皆さん。はじめまして、マイケルです。私の出身はプエルトリコです。
プエルトリコ。
でも、ニュージャージーに住んでいます。
ニュージャージー、アメリカ。
どうぞ、よろしくお願いします。私は日本の文化が大好きなので、日本語を勉強します。うん、日本を探検したい。
日本を探検したい。
地元の人と話すことができるようにしたい。
したいです。
ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。素敵な目標ですね。ぜひ。日本に来て地元の人たちと交流してください。とてもいい経験になると思いますよ。Thank you! Okay, then... The last one?
こんにちは、アメリアと申します。コロンビア人です。
うん、コロンビアから。
スペイン語とフランスと英語をお話します。
おー、3カ国語。
今長野市で住んでいます。とっても寒いです。スキーとトンカツを大好きです。よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。スキーとトンカツが好きだそうです。いいですね。長野県に住んでるんですね。今東京もとても寒いので、きっと長野県はもっと寒いでしょうね。雪降ってますか？ありがとうございます。Amazing work, everybody! Thank you so much for your submissions! Back to you, Arisha!
So, which entry did you like the best? Leave a comment below. Or, do you think you can do better? Here's the challenge for you. Yes, everyone watching this. Record a 30-second to 1-minute video or audio clip. Introduce yourself in the language. Share your name, where you're from, and why you're studying this language. And you'll win a 3-month Premium Plus subscription.To submit, click on the link in the description. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Then, fill out the form. Attach the audio or video file and press submit. We may feature you in next month's episode. So, a lot of learners will see you and your progress and will hopefully get inspired to improve and master the language. To submit a recording, click the link in the description and follow the instructions on the page. So, thank you for watching this episode of Monthly Review.Next time, we'll talk about the 7 tested, timeless ways to learn a language. In the meantime, like and share this video and leave a comment to tell us what language learning tactics you'd like us to talk about. See you next time. Bye.
Absolutely.
全くその通り。全くその通り。
All right.
いいです。いいです。
Are you all right?
大丈夫ですか？大丈夫ですか？
Are you on Facebook?
Facebook は使っていますか？ Facebook は使っていますか？
Awesome.
素晴らしい。素晴らしい。
Bye.
Bye bye. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. Bye bye.
Can I borrow this?
これを借りてもいいですか？これを借りてもいいですか？
Can I have a bag, please?
袋をもらえますか？袋をもらえますか？
Can I have a receipt, please?
領収書をもらえますか？領収書をもらえますか？
Can I sit here?
ここに座ってもいいですか？ここに座ってもいいですか？
Can I try it on?
試着してみてもいいですか？試着してみてもいいですか？
Can you download this file?
あなたはこのファイルをダウンロードすることはできますか？あなたはこのファイルをダウンロードすることはできますか？
Check.
保管上。保管上。
Congratulations.
おめでとう。おめでとう。
Could I have your attention, please?
皆様にお知らせいたします。皆様にお知らせいたします。
Delicious.
おいしい。おいしい。
Do you need anything?
何かいる？何かいる？
Do you speak English?
英語を話せますか？英語を話せますか？
Do you understand?
わかりましたか？わかりましたか？
Does this bus go to?
このバスは、に行きますか？このバスは、に行きますか？
Don't do it.
やめてください。やめてください。
Don't mention it.
どういたしまして。どういたしまして。
Don't worry.
気にしないで。気にしないで。
Everything is great.
どれもおいしいです。どれもおいしいです。
Excuse me, do you know where the is?
すみません。がどこにあるか知っていますか？すみません。がどこにあるか知っていますか？
Excuse me.
すみません。すみません。
Go straight ahead.
このまままっすぐ行ってください。このまままっすぐ行ってください。
Good afternoon.
こんにちは。こんにちは。
Good evening.
こんばんは。こんばんは。
Good morning.
おはよう。おはよう。
Good night.
おやすみなさい。おやすみなさい。
Goodbye.
さようなら。さようなら。
Happy birthday.
お誕生日おめでとう。お誕生日おめでとう。
Hello.
こんにちは。こんにちは。
Help.
助けて。助けて。
Hi.
こんにちは。こんにちは。
Hold on.
少しお待ちください。少しお待ちください。
How are you?
お元気ですか？お元気ですか？
How do I get to the?
にどうやって行きますか？にどうやって行きますか？
How do you do?
ごきげんよう。ごきげんよう。
How do you pronounce this?
これはどうやって発音するの？これはどうやって発音するの？
How have you been?
いかがお過ごしですか？いかがお過ごしですか？
How is it?
どうですか？どうですか？
How is your mother?
お母さんは元気ですか？お母さんは元気ですか？
How long will you stay?
どれくらい滞在しますか？どれくらい滞在しますか？
How many people are there in your family?
何人家族ですか？何人家族ですか？
How much is it to?
までいくらですか？までいくらですか？
How much is this?
これはいくらですか？これはいくらですか？
How much?
いくら？いくら？
How old are you?
何歳ですか？何歳ですか？
How is your day?
今日はどうだった？今日はどうだった？
How's the weather?
天気はどうですか？天気はどうですか？
Hurry up!
急げ。急げ。
I don't like it.
嫌いです。嫌いです。
I don't understand.
わかりません。わかりません。
I like it.
好きです。好きです。
I live in.
私はに住んでいる。私はに住んでいる。
I lost my phone.
私は電話をなくした。私は電話をなくした。
I need
が必要です。が必要です。
I need to go to the
私はに行く必要がある。私はに行く必要がある。
I understand.
わかりました。わかりました。
I'd like this.
これをください。これをください。
I'll have this.
私はこれにします。私はこれにします。
I'll have time next week.
来週なら時間があります。来週なら時間があります。
I'm
です。です。
I'm allergic to shrimp.
エビにアレルギーがあります。エビにアレルギーがあります。
I'm at home.
私は家にいる。私は家にいる。
I'm busy this week.
今週は忙しいです。今週は忙しいです。
I'm fine.
私は元気です。私は元気です。
I'm from.
私はから来たんだ。私はから来たんだ。
I'm full.
お腹いっぱいです。お腹いっぱいです。
I'm good.
元気です。元気です。
I'm hungry.
お腹がすいた。お腹がすいた。
I'm looking forward to working with you.
一緒に働けるのを楽しみにしています。一緒に働けるのを楽しみにしています。
I'm sorry I'm late.
遅くなってごめんなさい。遅くなってごめんなさい。
I'm sorry.
ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。
Is that it?
それだけですか？それだけですか？
Is that far from here?
はここから遠いですか？はここから遠いですか？
Is there a near here?
ここにがありますか？ここにがありますか?
It was nice to meet you.
お会いできて光栄です。お会いできて光栄です。
It's difficult.
難しいです。難しいです。
It's okay.
いいですよ。いいですよ。
It's really good.
本当に美味しいです。本当に美味しいです。
It's sunny.
晴れています。晴れています。
It's true.
それは本当です。それは本当です。
I've heard a lot about you.
あなたのことはよく聞いているよ。あなたのことはよく聞いているよ。
Just a minute, please.
ちょっと待ってくださいね。ちょっと待ってくださいね。
Long time no see.
お久しぶりです。お久しぶりです。
Make yourself at home.
自由にくつろいでください。自由にくつろいでください。
May I help you?
どうしましたか？どうしましたか？
May I sit here?
ここに座ってもいいですか？ここに座ってもいいですか？
My mother is well.
母は元気です。母は元気です。
My name is...
私の名前は、です。私の名前は、です。
Nice to meet you.
はじめまして。はじめまして。
No problem.
問題ありません。問題ありません。
No.
いいえ。いいえ。
Of course not.
もちろん違います。もちろん違います。
Of course.
もちろん。もちろん。
Once again, please.
もう一度お願いします。もう一度お願いします。
Please forgive me.
許してください。許してください。
Please have a seat.
お座りください。お座りください。
Please write it down.
書いてください。書いてください。
Please?
お願いします。お願いします。
Really?
本当？本当？
Same for me.
同じものをください。同じものをください。
Shut up.
黙れ。黙れ。
Slower, please.
ゆっくりお願いします。ゆっくりお願いします。
So, what's new?
それで何かあった？それで何かあった？
Sorry to keep you waiting.
待たせてごめんなさい。待たせてごめんなさい。
Sounds great.
いいですね。いいですね。
Stop here, please.
ここで止まってください。ここで止まってください。
Thank you very much.
ありがとうございます。ありがとうございます。
Thank you.
ありがとう。ありがとう。
Thanks.
ありがとう。ありがとう。
That jacket looks nice on you.
そのジャケット似合いますね。そのジャケット似合いますね。
This is for you.
これどうぞ。これどうぞ。
This weekend I'm going to the movies.
今週末、私は映画に行きます。今週末、私は映画に行きます。
Welcome.
ようこそ。ようこそ。
We're meeting someone.
待ち合わせなんですが。待ち合わせなんですが。
What are you doing here?
ここで何しているの？ここで何しているの？
What are you doing this weekend?
今週末は何をしているの？今週末は何をしているの？
What are you doing?
何をしていますか？何をしていますか？
What do you do?
職業は何ですか？職業は何ですか？
What do you feel like eating?
何を食べたい気分ですか？何を食べたい気分ですか？
What do you recommend?
おすすめは何ですか？おすすめは何ですか？
What do you want?
What happened?
何が起こった？何が起こった？
What time does it open?
開店は何時ですか？開店は何時ですか？
What time is it?
何時ですか？何時ですか？
What would you like to drink?
何をお飲みになりますか？何をお飲みになりますか？
What's for dinner?
夕飯は何？夕飯は何？
What's the next stop?
次の停車駅はどこですか？次の停車駅はどこですか？
What's the temperature?
気温は？気温は？
What's this?
これは何ですか？これは何ですか？
What's wrong?
どうしたんだ？どうしたんだ？
What's your favorite website?
あなたのお気に入りのウェブサイトは何ですか？あなたのお気に入りのウェブサイトは何ですか？
What's your name?
あなたの名前は何ですか？あなたの名前は何ですか？
When is your birthday?
あなたの誕生日はいつですか？あなたの誕生日はいつですか？
When will the plane leave?
飛行機はいつ出発するの？飛行機はいつ出発するの？
Where are we going?
どこに行きましょうか？どこに行きましょうか？
Where are you from?
ご出身はどちらですか？ご出身はどちらですか？
Where do you live?
どこに住んでいますか？どこに住んでいますか？
Where do you work?
どこで働いていますか？どこで働いていますか？
Where is it?
それはどこですか？それはどこですか？
Where is the?
はどこですか？はどこですか？
Where is the bathroom?
トイレはどこですか？トイレはどこですか？
Who is it?
誰ですか？誰ですか？
Who's going?
誰が行きますか？誰が行きますか？
Who's there?
誰かそこにいるの？誰かそこにいるの？
Why are you late?
なぜ遅刻しているんですか？なぜ遅刻しているんですか？
Yes, I do.
はい、そうです。はい、そうです。
Yes.
はい。はい。
You have good taste.
センスがいいね。センスがいいね。
You look gorgeous.
決まってるね。決まってるね。
Your smile is beautiful.
笑顔が素敵です。
笑顔が素敵です。
You're handsome.
ハンサムですね。ハンサムですね。
You're smart.
頭いいですね。頭いいですね。
You're welcome.
どういたしまして。どういたしまして。
Great work! Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description.